Another successful parachute test for Orion. How we're getting back to the moon. And an Apollo 11 virtual experience. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. We successfully tested our Orion spacecraft's parachute system recently at the U.S. Army Proving Ground in Yuma, Arizona. It's the seventh in a series of 8 tests to certify the parachutes for missions with astronauts. Meanwhile, another milestone for the program in Houston, the mock crew module for use in the upcoming Ascent Abort 2 test, was powered on for the first time. Ascent Abort 2 is a full stress test of Orion's launch abort system planned for April 2019.
In case you hadn't heard, NASA is going back to the moon.
A new vertical video on our Instagram takes you behind the scenes to show 5 ways we're working to get astronauts back to the moon in preparation for missions even farther into the solar system. To learn more about our moon and the agency's exploration campaign to return to the lunar surface and eventually send humans to Mars, go to nasa.gov/moon-to-mars.
Houston, Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
July 20th marks the 49th anniversary of Apollo 11's historic landing on the moon.
That's one small step for man,
Earlier this year, our spin-off publication highlighted Apollo 11 VR, a virtual experience made with NASA data. To mark the anniversary, here's a look at it in action. Immersive VR Education, a virtual reality-based education company, created Apollo 11 VR. The company used the trove of online NASA data, audio, and visual files from the Apollo missions to recreate the sights and sounds of the first moon landing in authentic detail. Developers also worked with Apollo 16 astronaut Charlie Duke, who tested an early version and helped improve the accuracy of the control panel for the final release. Apollo 11 VR is one of the many NASA spin-off products developed as a result of the agency's long history of transferring technology to the private sector. The SOFIA Flying Telescope completed 7 weeks of celestial observations from Christchurch, New Zealand. This deployment marked the first time the observatory's instrument that studies celestial magnetic fields was used in the Southern Hemisphere. The research could help astronomers better understand how magnetic fields affect processes that occur at the center of the galaxy and around newly forming stars. Observations made during the flights included the black hole at the center of our Milky Way galaxy, the Tarantula Nebula, supernovae, and more. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.